Texans start the season 1-5 for a second straight season. Taylor's stat line, by the way, 14 carries, 45 yards, two touchdowns, 28 fantasy points. And we mentioned T.Y. Hilton, four receptions on four targets for 80 yards. He led all Colts receivers. Texans next at the Cardinals next Sunday, so not getting any easier for them. Colts will go to the 49ers next week. The Colts cashed out on the spread, and the under hit on this one. We had Darius Leonard speaking after this one.
Darius, congratulations on the win. This is a big one. You guys had a short week, tough way that that ended in Baltimore, but this had to feel good.
Yeah, man, definitely feels good. Home game, divisional opponent. We wanted to come out and, you know, just make a dominant performance. We knew what we did on Monday night. We didn't finish the game there, so we came in hungry. We came in hungry and just wanted to compete and wanted to play hard.
Well, you were dominant yourself all throughout the game. Big plays throughout that game, Darius. And I just love the way you play football. What does football mean to you? How special is it to get out there every day and be able to play this game?
Man, it's great, man. I love football, man. This is my happy place. You know what I'm saying? Everything that I went through in life, and now I get to do what I absolutely love. And that's just the ultimate dream. And once I come out here, I'm very thankful. I'm very blessed. And I'm honored to come out here. So when I'm out here, I'm playing my heart out. I'm giving absolutely everything I got. And, you know, just giving all the honor to the great man above.
Darius, tell us about the ankle and where you are. We know it's been a tough road since the surgery in June. How do you feel physically?
I'm okay. It's not there. It's not where I wanted to be. But I'm good enough to play the game, and that's the main thing. So I just got to continue to take care of it and make sure that everything's good. And then hopefully maybe in the next couple of weeks I can be 100%.
I'm scared for offenses if you get to 100%, Darius.
Man, I can't wait to get back to 100, man.
Darius, we appreciate it. Congratulations.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Yeah, we're going to get to that the Kansas City stuff a little bit later in the show. But, Pete, I'll start by asking you this. Okay, so the Colts improved to 2-4. Over the next four games, I mean, they go to San Francisco next week, but they've got two division games in their next four. So, I mean, in terms of how the Colts, their outlook, I mean, they've got Tennessee, the Jets, Jacksonville after the Niners game. So, I mean, it seems like the Colts are kind of starting to find their form a bit, and the schedule kind of favors them.
And it's a bad division. And so you're gonna make, if you're a good team, you're going to win games and make up ground. Look, the Titans play Buffalo. That's a tough game for them. You're right back into it. Imagine if they hadn't had the field goal blocked at Baltimore the other night. I mean, they'd be sitting there pretty. So they're playing much better football. Throwing it around early, then you run it with the running back late in the game. It's the perfect formula to try and win football games.
You got to remember, they're getting healthy because Carson Wentz missed a huge chunk of time in the preseason with the foot injury. Quentin Nelson's still out. T.Y. Hilton just getting back. So now they're starting to get their pieces together. And so, okay, you had the stumbling out of the gates, you know, not ideal. But now you have your quarterback playing better. The run game is certainly dominating. And now you're getting the pieces coming around Carson Wentz. He's looking more comfortable. So now you can see that the Colts being a real threat in that AFC South. Like Pete said, not a very good division. They still have a chance to win that division easily.
Are you in on Carson Wentz in terms of what you saw today between him and T.Y. Hilton potentially?
You got to love it. You know, and this was a down game from Michael Pittman, who had been their number one guy. We still haven't seen, you know, everything working together. Nice to see Mo Alie-Cox finding the end zone. So giving them another presence in the passing game. So, again, you know, Paris Campbell making a play. T.Y. Hilton making plays. Last few weeks has been Michael Pittman. Now we see it all come together. Definitely looking up for Carson Wentz for sure.
Do you want a sports network that delivers everything that matters about the game? The highlights, the picks, the instant analysis. No yelling, no fake debates, no politics. Hit the subscribe button and never miss a moment.